84 in the first half, and you're Louisville with that beleaguered defense. You did a pretty good job.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty short kickoff taken by Noel Devine at the 15. Devine breaks out. Their freshman has room across midfield. Yeah, White and Slayton are fast, but so is this guy, the back of the future in Morgantown. 41 yards in a hurry.
You know what? When you talk about angles and trying to catch somebody who's fast, watch the speed. There's no way. They still didn't get a clean lick on him at the end of the play. They pulled him down. He almost split the two defenders.
Here are your angles. This is where you see White jerseys having no shot.
Bit of a wrinkle. They haven't used Devine much in kickoff returns this year. He's only had 38 carries. We saw him flash his speed at Maryland earlier this season. Thought he was going to become a bigger part of the offense. He's been a little bit nicked up. Had a concussion and it cost him a game. They fake the reverse. White still has it. Turns the corner, picks up about six as we check in with Aaron Andrews.
Five guys on defense, so that is a blow.
It is a blow. The starting defensive end out of there. Slayton on the reception. First down yardage to the 32. If they don't give him the ball as a runner, they can throw it to him. He had 17 catches on the year coming into the night. 7 yards on that one.
You saw Steve Krakthorpe on the sidelines telling his defense, pass. Here comes the pass. There's a tendency. There's a trend there. Gives his defense the heads up for the pass, but they're not over there.
He's been more involved in the defense lately, hadn't he? Mike Cassidy is the coordinator, but with that defense struggling, Krakthorpe calling things out. Yeah. It's not a run. It's a throw, and trying to break free. Raynard is thankfully okay after walking off the field to be treated in the first half. Buchanan on the stop.
Treated in the first half. Perfect segue to Owen Schmidt. He treats you to a ball game. Leading Pat White up inside. Finds his safety here. Leading right up inside again. Owen Schmidt continues to do the little things to make the offense look big.
On second and three, Slayton is the tailback. And he gets it. Slayton knifing ahead to the 11. That's his longest run of the night.
Well, we can add to Owen Schmidt's resume reel. What a block. Coming around, hitting Malik Jackson, you see from the right side. Here he is, going to come out, kick out on Malik Jackson.
By getting the fullback involved in the offense now, you can just go ahead and hand it off, though, to Slayton and not deal with all the reads that take the ball out of his hands.
First down. White firing short. Now Schmidt as a receiver makes a catch and picks up just one.
Good observation there, Chris. You said as a receiver. Three times now we've seen Pat White to the left side rolling. He's thrown to a slot. He's thrown to a receiver coming from the backside. Now he dumps it off to the fullback.
Well, they showed the same exact action that they just handed the ball off to Slayton with. The fullback coming across Schmidt, this time bluffs the block, releases into the flat.
Second and nine. They give a clinic here on this offense every summer. 1,000 high school coaches. It's grown from about 20 to 1,000 in 5 years. Came here to learn this offense. It's Slayton, and he's stacked up in the middle. A lot of high schools around the country are putting their best athlete at quarterback and running some variation of this offense.
Well, it's like Florida. When you look down at Florida, their option offense, their zone read, you see them at times, they'll go with a fullback leading. Here, they empty it out a lot.
You got to find a guy like Pat White, a quarterback, though. I mean, that's the key is that quarterback position, a guy that can read it all. They've even added the bubble screen into the read sometimes now. And
well, that may not be a Pat White, but if you got your fastest guy, your best athlete in
best
high school,
athlete,
you can still make guys miss at that level. On third and nine, pump fake, fire for the end zone. Leaping catch. Out of bounds. The late signal, Jock Sanders, the freshman. 28-yard field goal attempt from McAfee. And he's now hit 10 straight. So West Virginia marches the first possession of the second half and comes away with three. The lead is 10.
A text message from the friends. Give it the program.
We're making him famous tonight. Trent Guy at the goal line.
That's why he wore the tie.
Three flags fly. This guy is dropped to the 35. Something serious happened there.
Wow.
Zeliana, yellow laundry.
You got a flag out of the pocket there you want to throw?
That's a rotator cuff problem there.
Have a flag. You know, what accuracy. All three within a yard of each other.
Good bunching. It's an illegal block here. A nice fireworks show at halftime.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number two on the return team. Penalty is half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. First down.
And a coordinated fireworks, and now look at this. Flags in the air, all three of them.
Oh, yeah.
One, two, three. And they land close.
The kick returned by West Virginia, and then the penalty on theirs.
Tough field position. Short gain by Stripling. We said there's almost a victory for the Louisville defense after the kickoff return by Devine of 41 yards to hold the Mountaineers to a field goal. The deficit only 10 in the first possession of the second half, but not good field position.
That is a positive thing. If you can answer that with a touchdown drive and cut into the lead, no doubt. But as a passing quarterback, a guy that likes to throw the ball, you hate calling a run play on first down and getting stuffed and getting second and long.
And Brian was telling us more variety to looking different levels on first down throws, making the defense defend a lot of the field. But now on second and long, he's pressured and set near the 1 yard line. Keelan Dykes up the middle, got Brom.
We've talked about it tonight, how this defense has been able to stop Louisville on first down. Third down has been terrible. You're going to see three rushing, and look at the five across the board here. Nowhere for Brom to see the field down there and to throw to a receiver.
You have a double team on Dykes. He gets rid of the center and throws him off and just heads to the quarterback. Three-man rush. As a quarterback, you know receivers are going to be covered. I might have to move with the ball, and I should have a little extra time.
Brom sacked for a third time. Third and 17 from the one. He'll fire over the middle. It's Barnage in traffic, short of the first down. How many times tonight have the Cardinals come up just short of that first down marker?
Well, and hats off to West Virginia's defense.
Yep.
You know what? This is a defense that's playing like a top 10 team. They're coming out answering the call against an offense that can throw the ball and move it and score points.
Hey, what the third and 18 coming off your own goal line. That's a big play. Field position wise, not having to be backed up in the end zone punting. Sure, it would have been nice to pick up the first down and they were close to it. But at least you get a little bit of field position out of the end zone.
That's a shank. A terrible kick off the side of the foot. Rivers comes up and fields it on the hop at the 43. A flag on the play.
But did you see that? He threw the flag for 10 yards, wasn't far enough, picked it up and threw it another 10.
He doesn't have the arm anymore.
No, it's a rotator cuff issue.
Yet another special teams penalty.
You know what I'm talking about?
I hear you. Huh? Absolutely.
You throw something that's like, you know, half a pound.
Holding against the Mountaineers.
All right. Oh, there's the penalty out there.
But he has the slot release. So was to the side. He's babying it.
I didn't get enough
back
on that. I didn't get enough. Wait a minute. It's up there.
And he's going to sneak it in so that nobody sees that he's done it again.
Their flag got really near Rivers, who was trying to field that punt on the bounce.
Phil Judge, Ben, best consoles.
Could have been a little distraction.
Night. To see Dennis Dixon and the Ducks. On first down. And out straight ahead to Slayton. Loses the football. A fumble forced by Bobby Buchanan. And that's what Louisville needs. Louisville football. They've signaled that direction. They're still battling for it in the scrum. So Steve Slayton, who had those costly fumbles against Louisville last year, brought on by the wrist injury, the elbow problem that he had in the ball game. He came into this game bent on redemption. He's saying
it looked like this bounced out late. So Slayton really felt that his elbow hit the ground, and that's when the ball pops out.
Yeah, that's why. But you saw Cragthorpe tell him to get over and let's get on the ball and let's snap this thing. And Rodriguez doing a nice job of keeping his defense over there, saying, hold on, let's let this thing breathe a little bit.
Like trying to hit deer, not hit deer tonight. That's what I'm concerned about, not spelling Mountaineers.
On second and four, a first down completion. to the 35-yard line as Tito Gonzalez makes his second catch of the night. It's no reflection on the University of Florida education. You know how to spell Mountaineers, I know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even have attempted it, so.
Now that crowd's starting to come in. Get a little life to them.
Let's keep it going, Mounties. Let's keep it going, guys. We got this game. We got this game. All right, Mounties! On the team.
They haven't got it yet. If they get a touchdown here, it's going to look pretty good for them. You got Brahm on the other side. You got a chance. Slayton. Once again, not a lot of running room for the speedy Steve Slayton. Buchanan on the tackle.
Does appear to be getting closer, though. There's some creases, some positive gains, a half step from stepping out of an arm tackle.
You predict he's going to bust one here before this night is over?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can see only 40 yards rushing. That 103 per game is down about 30 yards from a year ago. A few less touches. Noel Devine now spells Slayton in the game. Whistle before the play.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 79 on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remain second down.
They got Isdener, the sophomore guard.
That appears to be the only way they'll get stopped. West Virginia makes some mistakes, whether it's penalties or turnover, mishandled snap, or the ball that happened to slip out of Pat White's hands he had to fall on. Boy, they're polished within the offense, though, when they're moving the ball.
Schmidt and Devine in the backfield. Second and 11 now. It's White. Ooh, he is popped. Ball comes loose. Pat White gets drilled after a short gain. And it is loose. Meanwhile, Brahm gets the football back. 8-12 to play in the third quarter. Down 10. Brahm.
As long as you can stand up and get out on the field, go.
Completion and a first down in the mid
in
the West.
In a few minutes and see if he still knows him.
Two tight ends for the Cardinals on first down. And hand it to Brock Bolin. Brahm, quick drop. Batted down. Batted down. Brahm pressured and hit. Ball loose. Picked up. Eric Wicks on a touchdown. An enormous game-changing defensive touchdown by the Mountaineers. Johnny Holmes made the hit. Eric Wicks scoops and scores. Here comes another review. Okay.
Again, it was a third and long situation. Allows West Virginia to come with the pressure.
Watch the arm here, guys. Was it going forward?
No.
No, not at all. Wicks is always around the ball. The guy, the ball just finds him.
He gets a lucky hop here, too, huh?
Gets a nice hop, scoop and score.
Jeff Castile dials up the right number at a critical time in this football game and bringing. Remember, we see.
1 second, Louisville's got the ball. Trying to cut into a 10-point lead. Now when Brahm goes back on the field, he's suddenly down 17. 44 yards as the Mountaineer defense steps up and makes its biggest play of the night.
Sit him down.
The enormous hit. Folks in the theaters in Morgantown love that. Wicks on the return, and now Brahm will go back to work after the big sack. Trent Guy trying to create field position, and Trent Guy, he's hammered as he hesitated just across the 30. Charles Pugh, he'd run by him, get back and made the hit. 30-yard return.
The goal line's that way.
Again, pressure. Brown fires. Incomplete. Douglas was well, or Barnage, you see, he was well covered, the tight end. Flag down.
Looks like Dyke splitting a double team again up front to get pressure on Brown.
Pass interference. Number 24 on the defense. Ball be placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
Ellis Lancaster, the backup corner, flag. They move the ball to the 38. Mountaineers tough enough to beat without a couple of turnovers that produced 14 West Virginia points, including the defensive touchdown.
If you want to beat these guys, you better hope West Virginia's turning the ball over. You better play flawlessly.
Doug Beaumont, the freshman, into the game and in motion in the slot. Brown flips it off and dropped by Anthony Allen. Tried to set up the screen. There was traffic, and he couldn't hold on to the ball.
Well, that's why they've had Stripling on the screens. What is he doing?
He's trying to prove that he's ready to go.
And that's going to do it, the old somersault test?
The somersault, he was just jogging back and forth.
That's the sideline test, you know?
If the hit knocks something loose in the head, you just do a somersault, and it'll get it back in place, right? Is that... If you started doing that, if I'm a trainer, I'm thinking that you just proved that you need to sit down.
And he did.
What is this, like tumbling class? You might not be ready. Second and 10. Deep drop and now a whistle. More concussion memories from my two partners here.
I got hit. Remember Mike Singletary?
Snap. False start. 72 on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Remain second down.
That's a backup guard, Brian Rhodes. So after the timeout,
whose knee hit me in the head.
On second and 15, Stripling trying to
blew it at the end.
And Matt Smith came up with that famous play in West Virginia history against Flutie. Louisville forced to punt. Cardinals have just 232 total offense mid-first quarter. Boy, Rivers living dangerously, makes the catch, takes a hit, and gets slung down at the 30. Concussion is okay. He's back in the football game as the Mountaineers take over, up 17 midway third quarter. This is Slayton. Fumbles again. Ball picked up in midair. Now there's a scrum. All of a sudden, fumbleitis for West Virginia. This will be first fumble to Slayton that counts. There's no way a replay is going
to. Pads down. Quit looking for the big play.
This is Stripling. Cardinals offense needs a big play here.
There's that tight end. That's a favorite target right there.
Brown looks left side.
Well, freeing up their partner.
Crucial play on third and six. Brown pressure gets it away. Now, Harry Douglas closing in on a 1,000-yard receiving year despite missing a couple of ball games with injury. Brown on the screen. It's Stripling. Has some blocks and picks up about 9 as we check it. Second and 1 now at the 13. It's Stripling. Straight ahead and hammers.
I don't know.
Shotgun on first and goal. Now a little zone read look there. Down here. Putting the ball in tight spaces. In motion, Douglas to the right. Whistle before the play. It'll be an illegal procedure to move it back 5.
Prior to the snap. False start, 81 on the offense, 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, the face says it all. It's a grimace from Bragg Thorpe. Scott Kuhn, the tight end, guilty of the penalty.
Charlie Stubbs, very aggressive in the red zone on first downs, throwing the ball. And with Brown, as accurate as he is, the play action.
Especially down here, play action can freeze linebackers in the zone. You get the tight end down through the middle.
Oh, jumped again.
Wow.
which they've already done today, getting the tight end down the middle.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 81 on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
You think second and 17 is a little different from second and seven?
That's a senior. That'll get you a personnel group change, won't it?
Okay.
Yeah, send him out there, Coach. You can regroup mentally, Scott, while we try to somehow punch this in the end zone.
They just wanted more space to work with.
Yeah. Okay. They're really in the ball game now. Still second and goal. Braun flips it, incomplete. He was trying to find Stripling across the middle, threw it behind him. Because of this guy, they have been a really efficient red zone team. They score touchdowns 73% of the time in the red zone. That's a top 10 of the country stat. Not quite as good as West Virginia, which is number one in the conference, but pretty good.
Well, now you just don't want to make that mistake and try to force it into the end zone and get the ball picked off. You need to come out with at least three here.
There's Harry Douglas right there. He's got to shake, bake, and get to the middle.
Brown, well protected, fires into the air, intercepted, a flag is down. Antonio Lewis knocked it free. And Langster weaving his way into the secondary. Ellis Langster,
great effort.
Finally going to be tackled at the 15-yard line. Again, a flag, two of them, way back in the end zone. Brom hustling down to make the tackle.
Great effort by Brom to make the tackle, but it's almost like just a fun thing. Let's watch him finish this out because we know it's coming back.
Well, that was Harry Douglas to the middle. You know what? Try to find a way to get him to shake and get open. He's the big play guy.
It's going to come back.
In that situation, you can't force the ball or force the issue. Take what they give you. If you have to kick the three, you're going to need three scores anyway.
Pass interference, number 21 on the defense. Ball be placed at the 2-yard.
And that was a pass interference on third and 17. Sets him up on first and goal. And Bolin hammering into the earlier in the evening, reversed by replay. Does make that costly turnover. All of a sudden, as Carmody was automatic. Talk more about that is. The fourth quarter unfolds. In the meantime, Mountaineers will go back on offense up 10. It's coming down there. I mean, did he need a brother to say that?
He should know himself, but sometimes you got to hear it from somebody else. And it gets frustrating as a running back.
Plus, he got hit pretty good on the play that he fumbled. It wasn't a careless fumble. He got hammered. Morrell Devine is the back, and he's got the ball. Set up a third medium yardage.
One thing that you can say about Louisville, Steve Kragthorpe came in here. He had to take over for a coach, brought in some new coaches, had four that were holdovers,
yep.
And he had to really work to find the players that would play for him, you know, that would come out and
he's
get
still trying
position.
To do that, isn't he?
He's still working. It's you know, a lot of work that he's had to do. More work than people would have thought. The casual fan assumed Louisville was just a layup job.
Fake from White, now he fires back on the far side. Catch made. Speeding away is Jock Sanders. Now he drops the football. Comes back and gets it. 23 yards, and Sanders, another true freshman, another Floridian. The Rodriguez and staff have recruited up to Morgantown in what's going to be the final play of the third quarter. He's got speed too, number 9.
Smaller the number, the faster you are.
White wants to go to the left. He confuses himself, comes late. I don't know if this was designed to be a choice or a double screen where he just set up with the pump.
Covered on the left side, went back right.
You can see that was no fumble. The ground caused it. So 15 minutes to play. West Virginia sitting on a 10-point lead.